one thing is scarier than skydiving, and that's being asked to tell them about yourself by a group of strangers in a formal setting. So today I'm going to give you a 10-step process to help you answer this trick question, which appears in every job interview. So hi, this is Enu Jain and you are watching CMA Enu Jain. So please press the subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it, and give us a thumbs up if you like my work. In this video, I'm going to give you one simple 10-step process to help you introduce yourself in any job interview. In fact, you can use this in any selection interview. Second, I'm going to give you some rules that go along with each step. And third, I'm going to talk about some common mistakes and how you can correct them. I'm also going to give you some stock phrases that you can use in your introduction if English is not your first language. And at the end of this video, I'm going to give you a complete introduction that you can use with your own customization. Tell me about yourself. This question comes in a number of different forms. For example, walk me through your background or take us through your resume. But whatever it is, this is a trick question, because the interviewer asking us to tell them about ourselves, and in fact they know everything about us by seeing that resume. So exactly what are they asking us to tell them? They're asking us for two things. One, they want to know our attitude towards work and what kind of a person am I. They want to know whether I'm a good fit for this job and what I can contribute to the company. So we need to catch their attention and keep them interested. Chances are they have had a full day looking at hundreds of applicants that look exactly like you. Here is your opportunity to prove to them that you are best suited for the job. And now on to that 10-step process. The first set steps that you need to take are about who are you. Step number one is called greetings. Now formal greetings are highly recommended, like good morning before 12 noon, good afternoon after 12 noon, and good evening anytime after 4:30 or 5 in the evening, all the way till midnight. Rules: smile, be confident, and make a good eye contact. And a common mistake are like saying hey, hi, what's up, and also fumbling between the good morning and good afternoon. Step number two, thank you for the opportunity. This is an optional step, and depending upon the situation, you could either say thank you for shortlisting me for the final interview, or thank you for this opportunity to talk about myself. Now, this will not only create a good first impression, but it will also help both you and interviewer relax a bit. Step number three is your name. Now, I'm Enu Jain. I'm Enu Jain. Or you can also say my name is, or my names. The rule is to smile, to be proud of your name, and to enunciate it clearly. And some common mistakes here are saying myself Enu Jain, or calling yourself Mr. or Miss. Now the question you have right now is, should I use my full name? And the answer is yes. Always use your full name, because simply using your first name may sound a little casual. Category 2. type of question or about why you are qualified. Step number 4, position and company. If you have work experience, then this is the time to tell them about the position you held, the name of the company, the number of years, any awards that you have won, and what impact you have had on the company, what difference you have made to them. For example, for the last 5 years, I have been a sales manager at .. leading a small sales team, and our team was awarded the best sales team of the year for 2 years in a row. I have worked closely with clients and built some key relationship. Example, I am a HR manager and blah blah blah, looking after the key function or recruitment, compensation, learning and development. I have over 5 years of experience in this field, and we have been able to increase our employee productivity by 8% during this period. Now the rules for this step. 1. Sound enthusiastic about your work. 2. Don't sound very pompous, like I'm a leader, I have done everything. Try to make it sound like you are a good team player. Rule number 3, tell them about something over and above what they can already read in your resume. And the 4th rule is, if you make a claim, try to give some proof to make it credible and believable. And the question you can ask me right now is, should I start to my most recent position and go backward, or should I start with my earliest work experience and come forward? And the answer to that is always start with your most recent position and talk about it, go backwards only if it is highly relevant or very important. Otherwise, your resume covers all of that. Step number 5 is qualifications. If you are a fresher, you are not going to be able to answer step number 4, and you are going to jump right into step number 5. So let's see some examples. I'm recent CMA from ICMA with prior work experience in the mining sector, or I have completed a bachelor in mass media degree with a specialization in a public relations and corporate communications, or I'm currently pursuing a 5-year of integrated law program at Dash School with a focus on cyber law. If your college is prominent and will not mention it, otherwise let it pass, common mistake. I'm a BMM from NMIS. So if you are a fresher, then just one line like, I'm a software engineer from so and so school, doesn't seem enough. So this is your chance to add achievement oriented mini stories. For example, like, I was part of a research project on how modern technologies changed the way of teaching in the future, where we worked with an ed tech company to evaluate the efficiency of some tech-based teaching intervention. Make sure you talk about a project in an area that's relevant to the employer. And if the area is not relevant, how about you talk about some skills that could be relevant? For example, you have recently done a project called The Impact of Gaming Consoles on the Youth, and you are just about to appear for an interview with a food marketing company. So how about you say this to them? This project helped us to understand the motivation of today's youths and how to attract their attention with our product and services. You can call also about any training program, courses or other experience that you might have had during your graduation. Question, should I mention my CGPA when I am just a fresher? Well, normally I would avoid it, because it's already there on your resume. But if you want to highlight your academic achievement, how about saying something like, I have consistently been in the top 1% to 5% of my class. Step number 6, additional qualification. This may include any outside courses that you did, skills that you gain, or your awards that you want. For example, I have completed a 6-month computer animation course from ... I am proficient in German and Spanish. I have learned .NET, .Java on Coursera, which have helped me in company in perfect on project on so and so. Step number 7 is called executive. Now use some executive to describe yourself to the interviewer. For example, you could be versatile, easygoing, solution oriented, determined, team player, creative, or just someone who enjoy working with others. Now, step number 8 is called hobbies and passions. This is optional, but you want to include this if this helps you build a connect with the interviewer. If you think they are significant or it helps you establish some skills that you want to demonstrate to them. For example, I'm a trained singer and doing daily riyaz has taught me self-discipline and dedication. Or I'm a keen runner and this not only helped me keep fit but also helped me network with other runners in the community. I recommended that you keep this section very, very brief. Set step number 9, family. Now this is optional. I would typically leave it out of a standard introduction, but you can choose to use it strategically if you wish. For example, my mother has been a housewife and during my vacation I helped her set up a small tailoring boutique at home with my savings for work. Or my father is a farmer and I helped set up process where he could directly sell his produce at the farmers market and bypass the middleman. Alternatively, you can use these techniques to answer this question on family when the interviewer poses this question to you later on during the interview. And the category 3 type of question is why you are here. Step number 10 is called closing. This is the point where you tell the interviewer two things. One, why are you applying for this job? And two, why are you a right fit for this job? You can also use your future plans and connect them to the company's goals. For example, although I love my current role, I feel I'm now ready for a more challenging assignment and this position really excites me. This is a very general statement and you can make it more specific and suited to the company, or you can show off your research that you have done about the company and add a little bit of a flattery to it as well as at this point. For example, with my passion for a sport and my skills of data analytics, I wish to work for a leading innovative sports analytics company like yours, and I do believe I can make a positive impact. And you can end your introduction by saying that's all from me. Thank you. Some rules to follow for step number 10. Read the job description so you can get some words from there that you can cleverly fit into this answer. And second, sound enthusiastic about the position. And now some final step. Tip number 1, write down your personal introduction and make sure you have included your top selling point for the position. This will vary from company to company, so make sure change and customize that every time you walk into the interview. Tip number two, jot down and learn only key points. Don't memorize the entire introduction or you're gonna sound like a robot. Let a little bit of a spontaneous hey come in, and don't worry too much about the grammatical errors that you think you might make. The third tip is very important. Limit your entire introduction to about a minute. 2 minutes, is it long? I would think 1 minute tops. Rule number four, maintain good eye contact and look confident while giving all these answers. If there are more than one people sitting in a room and only one person has asked you the question, don't answer the entire question looking at just that person. Look at everyone around the room, smile, relax, breathe and remain confident. Use a storytelling mode to tell about your accomplishment. You can use hand gestures if you wish. Don't do over the top, but you can use some hand gesture. Also sound excited, happy about everything that you have done in the past and everything you're going to do in the future. And now let's put it all together. And this is your sample introduction to on tell me about yourself. Okay, tell me about yourself. So good morning. First of all, thank you for this shortlisting me for this opportunity. My name is Eno Jain from India, but currently is studying in Abu Dhabi. I'm a qualified MBA and ICW with 4 years of experience in Vedanta Group as an accounts executive. My roles include preparing the cost sheet, MIS report, variance analysis report, assisting in budget sheet preparation and capex management. Apart from these, I was also responsible to manage the day-to-day functions of the project finance, like bank reconciliation statement, accounts payable, fund management, end-to-end handling to statutory and internal auditors, physical verification of inventory and closing related activities like closing all open GL outstanding and advances account and handling provisions. Additionally, I was also responsible for VAT report at a head office level and all these work done by SAP. Right now, I'm looking for an opportunity to apply my skills along with my creative problem solving skills to a company like yours. Thank you.